Welcome, welcome, welcome back. Now, you may remember in the last instalment of The Apprentice, Team Coalition, under the guidance of project manager Cameron, cocked up the big society task. Well, this week, it's the traditional abroad episode, where they desperately try and flog things to some foreigners. Here's the PM and his team, a bunch of suits, and John Major. They're in the Middle East, where they've got a week to sell as many guns as possible. And, of course, one of them is going to get fired, probably into a crowd of protesters. It's not an easy task. Guns are frightening. Just look at how the other team got on a few weeks ago when their project manager, Ed Miliband the Brand, visited Afghanistan. He looked petrified just standing near a soldier. Look at him nervously eyeing up the equipment. Good job the cap's still in. Watching ITN's coverage of Miliband in the war zone, actually, was like tuning into an episode of Peep Show. Here he is, looking worried, just gazing at a map. I kept expecting to hear David Mitchell's voice on the soundtrack.
Oh, like God, this. It's a map. I'm in a war looking at a map. How the fuck did this happen?
Luckily, Team Coalition don't have such concerns because project manager Cameron doesn't feel fear because he isn't programmed to experience emotions. Look, here he is, walking like a recently activated robot. Seriously, he's either shat his trousers or he's some kind of ceremonial sales droid. Cambot 4000 must be excited about this trip because it gives him a chance to leave behind the human bustle of London and its whining meat organisms who emit basic ape cries as he coldly dismantles their hospitals. He can forget all of that for a few days at the high-tech arms fair, where he'll unwind with some like-minded machines, do a few cheeky lines of code, and who knows, maybe hook up with a sexy young targeting system who'll let him empty both gigs and then wipe clean his dongle. Hey, what happens at DEFCON stays at DEFCON, yeah? Anyway, the fun sales trip has been spoiled by an awkward flowering of democracy in the region as millions of people rise up against some of the arms industry's best customers, which means Cameron's had to make loads of speeches, like this one in Kuwait, in which he stood in front of a row of life-size I Love London souvenir soldiers, passionately explaining that it's shooting people is wrong. Well, how the hell is that going to shift these British weapons, you wuss? Don't go banging on about democracy like your Shami Chakrabarti. Come on, Cameron. If you were a true patriot, you'd be standing in the square holding this and shouting, death, death for sale, I'm selling death, everyone. Look at me, I'm selling mechanised, unthinking death. As seen on Libyan TV, get it while it's hot, it's lovely. David.